Right, welcome to my channel. Sorry I haven't been on for a long time. But my hubby hasn't been very well. He's been really, really poorly. And I've had to basically nurse him a bit. He's, well, a lot, sorry. He's had gallstones. And he's also diabetic. He's been in hospital, had them removed. One of the gallstones, they were really huge. He'd got one really huge bladder, one really huge gallstone, and about 10 other gallstones that were also there. So he was in a really bad way. He's had a 10-inch scar all the way across his stomach. But he had to have part of his bladder removed as well because one had gone and sort of made its way into his bladder. So he had to have part of his bladder removed. So, and then it got infected. So yeah, wasn't very well. So I'm back now, and I'm finishing this magazine journal off. I can't remember if I did the cover, but I put the cover on. I'm afraid I didn't do a lot of filming because I was stressed a lot of the time, and this was the only way, my only sort of outlet, if you know what I mean. So I'd just sort of come home sometimes and I'd just do a bit of crafting and fall asleep. I'd do it for about half an hour and asleep again, so I weren't very well. Right, this is just PVA glue, but it's like a builder's PVA glue, and it's pretty good. I call it PVA bond and not blonde, PVA bond, and oh my god, it is really good strong glue. So anyway, what I'm doing now is I'm putting a cover on, and I've decided I'm going to put a fabric cover on this journal. My nephew's been down several times. So yeah, I've just got to cut it out now, basically. Okay, so I'm just gonna measure how much I need, really. I'd rather have more than not enough. And this fabric I've got here, it's just an old t-shirt. It's nothing fantastic. It's just an old t-shirt that I've cut up that my daughter has put for the rag bag. And it's not going to be for the rag bag, it's for me. Right. And because he wants everything black, this is black material. Dog hairs on it. Do you know, there's nothing in this house that doesn't get dog hairs on. Right. Just cut this off. It's quite a nice shirt, actually, and I'm cutting it up. I'm just going to make sure it's gonna fit right. And then I'm gonna glue it. Put loads of glue on to make it stick. I don't want to bore you with the gluing process, but this is just some fabric. Oh, it's not in, you can't see it. I've been trying to choose from some fabric. This is just a base fabric because I found a really nice lace fabric that I'm going to use, and it's ever so nice, which I'll show you in a bit. I'm just going to put this on liberally, really chip it on basically, so the fabric sticks. So basically this is what I'm doing. So I'll pause it and then come back to you when I've done that. Right, I've applied loads of glue. I'm just going to put quite a few dabs on because I really want this fabric to stick. I don't want it to be coming off. And I have used a crisp box as the cover. You've probably gathered I like Snoopy. I am obsessed with Snoopy. Love Snoopy. I have Snoopy little, you know the McDonald's toys, what you get, the Snoopy McDonald's toys. I've got loads of them in my bedroom, in my Doggylicious room where I do dog biscuits. And then you just sort of fold it over. Make sure it sticks. And don't worry about the glue coming through because it'll dry clear. So don't worry about that. You can sew to make it stick. You can sew the cover if you want, you're quite entitled to do that. But today I am deciding that I want to do it with glue. And then I'm going to do the other side. So basically I'm going to do the same on the other side as what I've just done there. And I'll come back to you when I've done the other side because I don't want to bore you. We're watching me glue it and do it again. Okay, so I'll come back in a bit when I've done this side. You basically do on this side what you've done on the other side. Okay? I'm chewing a piece of rock, by the way. We went away for the day. And I can never come back without rock or nugget. Rock, nugget and fudge. Oh dear me. I'm just going to get something to clean that. Oh dear me. It's a quiet day today. It's very overcast. I'm done. Which is perfect for me. I love weather like that. I don't like it when it's all sunny because it hurts my eyes and I get migraine. Right, so all that is on. I think what I'm going to do is let that dry, leave it like this to dry, and I'll trim it off when it's all dry, so you'll probably see that in that part. I can't even remember what part it is. I think it's part 9, part 8, I'm not sure. But that's going to dry. I'm going to put that to one side and let it dry. And I'll show you what else I've been doing. Right. What I've been doing is making triple envelopes to go inside the journal. And I've done in 3. I've not quite finished them yet. And what they are, he loves dragons, as I think I said that in the other tutorials. So I've put dragons on, and obviously he likes black, red and green. and silver. I couldn't find any colours like black, red and green. Well, I could find black, but I couldn't find the red, green and silver to go on here. And all I basically did were get each envelope, and I should have really, I haven't got any envelopes to, I've got some here I haven't done, and you just glue this bit onto there, and you leave, I don't know how much it is, just about this much, you see, about that much of a gap, just so you can fold it up, and the flap will fold over. Otherwise, if you don't do that, it crunches and it just won't fold over, and it's a pain. So basically, you do that. My husband's doing some. He's sharpening my punches for me because they've gone blunt. And then before I did that, I sprayed all the envelopes with food colour, watered down food colour. I did this in red, blue and green. And it made a beautiful colour. And then when it had dried, I attached this here. And I'll show you how you make it look like this. So, just trying to find some, yeah, that would do. You get some paper, just anything. I tea stained it. You tear it to, don't cut it, because you want that ragged look. You need it to look raggedy. And you just tear it so it's all rough. And make sure that you do it to the size, oops, sorry, wrong side. You do it to the size of the envelope here. Okay, and make sure it's going to be the right side up. So, yeah, it needs to be that side. This needs to be facing up. Because there's only two, it doesn't need to be. Because with three, when you've got three, you need one facing up, the middle one facing down, like the wrong way, and then the bottom one facing the wrong way. Reason being, you see what I mean? Look, they're all facing, that one's facing the right way, and then that one's facing the wrong way, and so is that. So when you turn it round and you fold it, that's facing the right way, and then that's facing the right way when you fold that. And so is that. You'll work it out. If you get a bit confused, what you're best off doing is, I start from the bottom up, and I start from the top down, and I do that one first, and then I realise that one needs to be that way, and then you do that one, and then if you fold it like that, you'll see which way it needs to be. And if it helps, underneath, put a little arrow facing which way it needs to be. And you'll sort it. It sounds complicated, but it's quite easy. Anyway, and then just here. Make sure it's the right size to your envelope. Because you don't want it looking perfect. You want it to look straggly and messed up, basically. That's better. And so you have it where it's like that. I mean, if you're not happy about this being down here, tear that bit off. I'm quite happy with it being like that. And then you just glue it. Make sure that you put it all down. All the corners do not have to be stuck down. So make sure that goes that way. Okay. I mean, I've only done two here, but if you want it to be a third, you just do the same, add a third one on, and you've got your three. And then you fold, you find your picture. I'm just going to find a picture. Just a right, I found a picture, which is a picture of a beautiful horse. I think that's absolutely lovely. You do the same for this picture. You tear it. And then you just. Oh, I haven't aged it. Oh, I've just realised I haven't aged it. Oh, it doesn't matter. This is going to be one for me anyway. But usually, before you put it on, if you want to, you age the ends. And it's going to look daft, but I don't care because this one's for me anyway. I found a new trick. My hubby's just brought my punch back because I bought this second hand, and the lady led me to believe they were working, da di da di da. And I must admit, I bought a bunch. I bought a load. I think I bought nine. And I bought nine for £20. Two weren't working. And all the rest were as blunt as anything. They just wouldn't punch out. He's just sharpened them for me. And now this, I've just sort of, so I'm quite happy now. He's just got all the other lot to do, so yeah, that should be fun for him, keep him happy, totally occupied. So, excuse my husband's language.
All of these monkeys, aren't they?
All of them, yes. All the lot. Right. Right. You know how you buy the distressed dyes? Distressing, sorry about that. Well, I haven't got any. I haven't run out. I just hadn't bought any. I've been meaning to buy some, and I kept forgetting. And all this was made with blusher brush. And I have them all. I've got loads of makeup here. Not what I don't use it. I haven't found a use for lipstick yet, but I'm sure I will find a use. But it's all done with eyeshadows and blusher brushes, and what you do, you wet the end or glue it. It's up to you, but very, very, very fine. Just sort of touch it with, you sort of, there's hardly any glue on your brush. Make sure you've not got much on at all. Or if you don't want to use glue, just use water or tip of your tongue. It's up to you. But that's not really good enough for what I'm wanting there. I really would could I want a brush, blah, 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 a blush. A blush I had all these given me. Lovely lady gave them me. Because I don't really wear makeup. But yeah, I'm not bothered what colour I do it because it is mine anyway. But yeah, and you can sort of de-stress it or get it on your finger, sort of go along. Basically, you just need it wet so it takes on that aged feel. And I can't believe I didn't do this before. But hey ho. Can you see? I'm sorry, I've just realised you can't see what I'm doing. You just rub it. Get it on your finger. Your fingers will end up mucky, as you can see. But yeah, just, you know, if you don't want to pay for distressed eyes. I mean, you don't get as good a effect, but it's a bit more there. Oi! But it's not bad. I don't think that's too bad. I think that looks lovely. And when you've got these, all I'm just going to do is just... I mean, I've still got my fingers a bit wet. And I'm de-stressing a bit. So, you don't necessarily always need distressed eyes because you can still get a lovely distressed look with blusher or eyeshadow. And you can get a nice colour. I mean, if you want to use pink, you can use pink, you know, depending on what picture it is. And there's my distressed look. And I think that looks quite nice. That's rather nice, you know, so. And that's going to go on there. I like the way it looks. I mean, some people might not like it and think, oh, I'd rather buy distressed eyes, and that's up to you. It's everybody's prerogative, you know. I'm sorry, I think I'm going off camera here. I'll sit the chair back up a bit. And there you have it. Jenny! No! And they, you know, and that looks distressed to me. It's lovely. Jenny! It's all nice and distressed, and I think that looks beautiful. You know, I haven't finished it. I'm still going to do a bit more. And then, to know what side it needs to be, just turn it round like that. And you get another pink. Just a moment. I'm just going to see what they're barking at. Postman has just been with my things that I ordered. I don't know if anybody shops on June. There's June Wish and, oh, there's another one, I can't remember what it's called. But I used to shop off Wish a hell of a lot. And Wish is excellent, it's fabulous. But the only problem is with Wish, you pay your postage. And then somebody told me about one called June, J-O-O-M, and you install it on your app just like you do Wish on Play Store app. And the good thing is with June, you don't pay postage. The only time you really do pay postage, I think, is when stuff's free. You know, when you get stuff's free that they let you have, you pay postage on that. But everything else is just, you don't pay postage at all, which I think is tons better. I don't like saying it is better than Wish, So I will let you see what I've got from June this morning. Is it this morning? Oh no, it's afternoon. Oh my god, I remember ordering these. Oh, look at them. I've been waiting a while for these. That is the only downside. You do wait a while, but it's worth it because you get stuff cheap. I think I probably paid £2, maybe £3 for them, which I think's, you can't go wrong, can you? So that's that one. This is a little one. I'll go and fetch what I got. I had some come yesterday. I'll show you. Hang on, just a minute. Thank you.
Some of these stars might not sharpen.
I know.
I've got a...
That weren't so bad. That one weren't so bad at punching out, so that star one might not be so bad.
Here, the clip on either side, you pop off.
Yeah. Like I said, the star one might not be so bad. It were every other one that were a bit...
I'm
not going to shout them all. Yeah. Thank you, babes. I got this, which is... I got it for my nephew because I'm doing that journal for him and he loves cats. He's got, I think he's got three. Yeah, three. So I thought I'd put some die-cut cats in. And this cost £2, believe it or not. Look at the size of that. That is absolutely gorgeous. That's £2. So, and I think what I might do is use that as like a, you know, like to protect corners at books. I know it's a bit big, but I think it's beautiful. That would look gorgeous on corner at books. Anyway, where's my scissors? I'm sorry, this has been long-winded, this video. I'm sorry. I'm going on. Oh, my teddy bear. I ordered a teddy bear. It looks like Tatty Teddy. You know the Tatty Teddies? That is gorgeous, isn't it? Look at him. And I know what these are. I ordered some, I'm hoping, this is like the butcher's, I ordered some butcher's twine. And I think they were £2, they were either £2 or £3. Knowing me, I don't think I'd have paid more than £2, so I think they were £2 each, if I remember. I'm sure they were. And I'm going to order some more. £2. You can't go wrong. And the great thing is, like I say, you don't pay postage. You do not pay postage. Now, if you was to go and buy that from Hobbycraft or anything like that, you'd be paying like £4 a roll, probably more. So, I'm going to build my collection up. I've got red, pink, green, brown, black, and I can't remember what else I've ordered. Pink. Yes. So, yeah. They're me deliveries. Quite happy with them, I am. But that I think that's... I were expecting it to be a bit smaller, but it weren't. It's just awesome. I love it. Anyway. Put that there. Oh, they're fantastic. You know, swore then, I'm sorry. Right, anyway. My husband keeps pinching my bits of paper because he keeps testing, so I need some more. I keep picking wrong bits out. I've done a load of tea stained paper and I'm after somewhere to picture on. Oh, that's nice, that would be nice actually. Oh yeah, I could have that. Now this don't anybody shout at me. But this is like a, I don't know what it was, it's from like a Bible page, but they were music sheets. But, and I know people don't like you ripping Bible pages up and whatnot, but I will admit, I can see where you're coming from. I am not I'm not religious at all, totally not religious. But the Bible I was buying, it cost me 20p, and the book was literally falling apart. Literally. The pages were coming out, and the guy, I bought it for 20p, and he said if I didn't buy it that day, it was going in the bin. So I basically saved it. So I can understand what people mean with Bibles, because I'm not religious, but I can understand, if you know what I mean. But yeah, I only bought it and I only used them because the book was literally falling apart. And what I'm going to do, when I've used all the sheets and everything from the Bible, the actual hard stand book, I mean, it's only a tiny book, as you can see, because they're only small sheets. I'm going to make a little journal out of it, and I think it'll be lovely. It's actually, I'll show you the I'll show you the Bible. Right, here's, you see what I mean? It's felt a bit, so it's just got old, and the pages are falling out. They're just coming loose, I just love the pages. They are so thin and frail, and I paid 20p for it. And I got a bigger one. That were the same. The bigger one was slightly in better condition, but not much. The spine's gone on that one as well. I can't find that one, but the spine's gone on that one. But yeah, they're just not in. But I do like, I don't know what it is. Oh, the Methodist hymn book with tunes. But it's lovely. I love how it's got the rounded edge on here. So it will be beautiful. It's been scribbled in as well, which is a shame. Kids have scribbled in it, and but it's all just falling apart. But it will come in handy, and it'll be so beautiful. But yeah, I'm going to put that on my... I think that will go beautifully there. I'm not even going to rip the edges, because I just like how it looks. Yeah, I'm gonna leave that like that. So, I'm wanting a picture. It's got to be... Oh, that's pretty. And it's another horse picture as well. Yeah, use that one. I bought a horse book called Danny, I think it was called. You see it? It's beautiful. So I'm going to use that. Can't really. The books are no good to me because I can't read them because I'm visually impaired, so I can't see the lettering. If I try and read a book, I get a really bad headache. So it's just not. It's not going to work for me, I'm afraid. But visually impaired or not, I want to still keep on doing what I want to do, and I like doing this, and that's what I'm going to do. So anyway, I'm going to do this last one. I'm going to finish doing this, and then I'll do a part whatever. I hope you don't mind me doing as many as what I'm doing. If you do, I'm sorry. You don't have to watch me. Just go and watch something else. I don't mean to be awful saying that. I don't want to annoy people by going on with my videos. I don't think a lot of people watch my videos at the moment anyway. It would be nice if people did like and subscribe my videos, because it to be honest, to see what people think of my videos. I don't know what anybody thinks because nobody comments on them. But hey ho, makes me happy. I'm doing this and I've not died yet again. Oh, do you know, Teresa? Oh, I've not put it on. Don't tear. Oh, it's going to have to stay down. It's just going to have to put it a bit wonky. It's not like it's for anybody special. It's for me, so. And I'm going to use this here. Just going to de-stress it again, like I showed you earlier. This is slightly darker eyeshadow. So when you have old eyeshadow that you think is just no good and it's only good enough for the bin, Just rethink before you throw it in the bin, because you can reuse them, and I know you can use them as embossing powders as well, but. And I'm sorry, my husband has got his telly on loud, but he's a bit deaf. If he has his telly on any lower than where he has it, he'll not hear it. So I do apologise. So, you know, it's a bit grungy, which is, I'm happy with that look. I think that look is quite nice. I know it's probably, well, it's got a sheen to it as well. It's got like a really like metallic sheen. Can you see that? Oh, that's quite nice. Oh, that's lovely. And then I'm just going to put a bit of glue on the sides here. And instead of, I'm just going to rub, you know, like you would, you normally would, do you know what is up with me today? I can't even talk. Distress inks. Like, would you distress inks when you run along? I just use the whole pad and I think it does just as good. I think it looks lovely. I think they do. Oh, did you hear that? That's my husband. I apologise for that. My husband's having a few choice words in his room. I do apologise for my husband's foul language. I'm just as bad though, I must admit. When things get me mad. No fair. Mister. Don't use me new paper. Hang on. Let me get you some old paper. Here, that's not been stained or anything. I don't want to be using the tea staining paper. That one seemed to do it with ease, didn't it? Mm. Thank you very much, Bebe.
Please don't throw them away now.
Well, I was gonna because I was ready to throw them out the window. Oh, they were annoying me that much. haven't finished it yet. I've got to. I don't know what I'm going to do with that yet. Oh, I know what I can do. Oh, yeah, I know what I can do. I bought some new tissues. My workstation is a mess. Absolute mess. So, there's a use for your old eyeshadows and blushes, and don't throw them away. And I know some people do, but don't throw your eyeshadows and stuff away, because they come in handy. I mean, if you don't like that look, then don't bother. But I think it looks quite nice. And something else I saw as well. I haven't got any, so I can't show you. I saw somebody use watercolour pencils as like, you know, a distress sort of thing. They went along the edges and they just sort of smudged it along the edge, and then they sort of wet the finger a little bit and then dabbed it, and then they just went along and it looked fabulous. So I've got to get myself some watercolour pencils, because I'm going to have a go at doing it that way as well. I'm all for, if you can save a bit of money, but I still have the same effect, sort of, then I'm all there. And I just think that looks great. I think it looks fabulous. And you get like a nice metallic sheen, which I like. I think it's brilliant. Right, I'm just going to go and get the tissues. Right, I've got these tissues. To be honest, I can't remember where they were. Card Factory. They were selling four packs for £1. I think it were £1 or £1.20, but I didn't think it were bad, to be honest. I thought that were absolute excellent money. And they're not a full size tissue, but not a bad size. And they're going to go on here. And I think they'll look lovely. Lovely tissues, beautiful. Oh, and they peel easily, you know. And here, a little tip for you, if you don't know. You know, if you struggle taking, if you struggle to get the tissues off, you know, instead of trying to find it, you know, instead of trying to pick it like this, I'm visually impaired and it just doesn't work. So what I do, I get my finger in my mouth, just dab my finger on my tongue, and then rub my finger together, like that. And it grabs it. It just grabs it. Instead of messing about trying to find it. I mean, if you don't like doing things like that, putting your finger in your mouth or anything, then a dab of glue or dab your finger in some water and sort of just dab it off before you do it. No problem. But anyway, I've been dying to use these tissues. Absolute dying to use them. Really have. Right. Do this tutorial, and I'm gonna put. Can you see what I'm doing? You just sorry. I'm not telling you what to do, am I? You just sort of. Just wet. Do it. Put your glue on. Get your tissue. You don't wet here. You just wet where the opening for the envelope is, just that bit there. Don't go any further. I got this off a lady, I can't remember. I'm sorry, I have terrible memory loss. I'm not very good with my memory. I take tablets, and certain tablets I take that make me forget. Ooh. The tablets make me very forgetful. If I do remember what a name is, I'll put it on. I'll put the link description. But I have subscribed to her, so I'll have a look and find her name. Are we done? That one looked a bit harder. You did it though.
I pushed that hard because I thought it was going to be bad, but I didn't have to really.
Right, we'll do it without pushing hard then. Because. Yeah, I did it then. Oh, that's a lot better. Because when I've been trying, it's been ripping paper and. Thank you so much. If I lose a couple, then I lose a couple. But like I said, all I'm going to do is going to bin them anyway. So, it's a bonus. Well, there's...
Especially that one.
There's a Friskers one, that one you've got in your hand, that Friskers one, I think it's knackered, it's gone. Every time you try and push down, it rips paper, it's terrible.
Oh, okay.
Which I'm surprised, because Friskers is a good make.
Oh.
And then you just cut it. Oops. I really like this serviette, so it's precious to me. I don't want to. So you just sort of trim it down. So. Do you know, I always end up cutting part of envelope me. So, I'll just tear that bit off. And there you are. And I'm going to let that bit... Oh, I'll cut it now. I was going to let it dry. When it dries, you can sort of pull it and you can take off the bits, really, and you can sort of sort it out. There you are, isn't that pretty? And then you pull it up like that, and that goes over. I think what I might do is put this one over here like that. It's not big enough. So I'll have to do another piece, which is not a problem. I've got one here. I'll just put that on, and I think that'll look lovely. And I can do it on that bit as well. So, and then I'll just do this bit. So, you get an idea how to do them then. And then you know, with these ones here that I've done, you know how they've been done. And I haven't really finished it off, I've still got to finish these off a bit. But I'll show that in another video. I've not decided what I'm going to do with them yet, so. I just want to do something a little bit extra. Not quite done yet. Thank you. you can do if you don't like cutting away while it's still a bit damp, you can always do you know what, I'm going to trim around there because I'm going to use that bit for this top bit. You can always wait until it's dry and then cut round. But I'm just impatient. I'm so impatient. So let me just cut round this bit here. You know what? I was going to put some there and there, you know, on these bits, but I think it's going to be too much. I'm not going to bother. And I think what I'll do, I'll put one on here, but not on there. And I'll do the same with that. I'll use the same tissue, the black and white tissue I've used on the others, on them. So I'm going to that looks nice. Oh, do you know, I've just realised I'm out of ask bloody camera when I'm doing that. I'm so sorry. I'm just trimming the ends of the... I'm so sorry, I didn't realise. I just realised I'm doing that. Silly woman! Right, and then you fold that up there like that. And bring that over. Put one there. It's all right for there, but I've just, it's going to be too much, I think. And I'll put one there. I don't like wasting everything. To make as much use as I can of things. But these are, I'll just hold on to these little bits, I won't throw them. And they can get used in something else. Do you know, I've got to use another bit of tissue. I don't know if to, I think, I might use. Because it's got bits about horse as well, so I think what I'll do, I don't know where my bloody pen's gone. Got a new clock. revived. Absolutely love rock. And I prefer humbug and aniseed. I love humbug and aniseed rock. And I cannot come home without buying any. Huh?
Around most of it, some of it is a bit dead. Trees?
Alright.
Oh! Oh, that went better than I thought.
Didn't it? What do you think? That bit.
That's rubbish.
Just chuck it on the table. After I've done this, I'm going to go and hang washing out and sort stuff out. And I'll go to the shop. That bit. Can't make my mind.
Or that bit.
That bit. Yeah, I thought it as much. It does, doesn't it? It might blend
in. All these
backing
blocks are working.
Thank you very much, baby. Don't you dare turn my light off. Can't be in darkness. Yeah, that does look better than the. I was going to put tissue on, but it's too much, isn't it? Because it's got it on the other side as well. Yeah. That does look better. That looks so much better. There we are. Got to trim it down because it's just needs a little ring thing putting on there so it can be folded, fastened. So anyway, I am sorry. Oh, I've realised it's nearly an hour long, this video. I'm so sorry. Anyway, very long-winded. I hope you like my video. But like I say, if you want to make this a where it's a triple one, like I have done with this one, you just do the same. Add another with the flap, this bit, you add it on there. And don't forget to leave a gap. Okay? And there you are. Thank you for watching my video. Bye bye. Please subscribe and share.